Spurs. Okay, so Dean Ashton, we could talk about the quality of the opposition. Let's just go with that premise that you can only beat what's put in front of you, and Spurs beat them comfortably and were very entertaining to watch as well.
They were, yes. I think it's daft that that's a surprise, isn't it, to think of a Tottenham team that aren't entertaining. For as long as I've known Tottenham, they've always been an entertaining side. So for that to be all I read on Twitter after the game is how much better they were to watch is a surprise. But they were, and there were some good performances, some standout performances from obviously the names that haven't been in the team. Dele and Bale, I thought both were excellent when they're on the pitch.
Okay, and listen, we are well aware about the opposition.
Yeah.
I get that. But here's the thing, because he has been nervous, I think. I didn't think I'd ever describe Mourinho as nervous, but I think he's been nervous to put all four, not just that front three they were talking about, all four in the same team. Kane, Son, Dele Alli, Gareth Bale. I think now, given that Dele Alli has done all that was asked of him, come in and played really well. He scored, it's an unbelievable finish for the first goal. So he's played really well. So does he deserve to be left on the bench at the weekend against Burnley? I don't think so. And so I'm looking at it thinking, has Jose got to let his own handbrake off and play all four of them at home to Burnley on Sunday?
I think so. I mean, I watched obviously the game. I was there for talkSPORT on Sunday against West Ham. Bale came on. He was by a country mile the best player on the pitch. Completely changed the way the game was going. Everything that was good went through him. And Dele Alli came on and tried to have an impact. And he's then been given a chance last night and took that chance. I thought not just the goal. His all-round performance, I thought, was much more like the old Dele Alli, getting into the box. Like you say, with the goal, it wasn't just that. The actual build-up before the goal was excellent from him as well. And because Jose likes, at the moment anyway, to play the two holding midfield players, then it sets up perfectly to be able to give that front four a certain amount of license to and freedom to just go and play and hurt the opposition. I think it is time. I think it's time. They deserve, with the way that they've played, certainly in the last couple of games, Lamella and Lucas Moura, I don't think have done quite enough to warrant the starting place.
Yeah, I think to a certain extent, his Spurs reputation, Jose, is on the line. If he plays Jose Borg, reverts back to type on Sunday, and it's a difficult game to watch, and Burnley will try and make it a difficult game to watch on Sunday, away from home at Spurs, then it could be an absolute shocker. He's got a real opportunity here, and you're spot on with what you said. If he tells the back four and the two in front to be defenders, you know, I'm talking very broadly here, that means that those four at the other end can do their thing, surely.
Not even the back four. Two centre-backs and two holders. That should be enough for a Tottenham side against Burnley. That should be enough. If you think Burnley, within reason, Dwight McNeil, I would say, is a threat. But generally, it's going to go into the front two, isn't it?
Yep.
Or over the top. If you've got two banks of two there, you should be allowed to give license to some attacking players the freedom to go and play.
Yeah. So basically, they will play the two up top. If Barnes and Wood are fit, it will be them. And therefore, you put the two holders in front, two centre-backs behind. Sorted. Should we apply for the job? You be my assistant. Is that how it works?
No.
That was our choice of the Big Match Maestro with McDonald's McDelivery. Order McDelivery now on the Uber Eats and Just Eat apps.